Cornette instructional films, shaming white children for nearly 70 years. Oh. Based on the Lester Dent pulp novel Joan Avoids a Bullet. Pretty sure the book was probably better. Well, your nipples sounds okay.
The guardians of our health, our doctors, nurses, teachers, and parents are working together to keep us well. All of them must know and agree on the health practices
like
we
choosing
need
the right hat
home, in the neighborhood and at school. This is Joan getting ready for
Joan
school.
Is kind of a poor man's
Joan
Shirley Temple.
That it's important to choose the right clothes on a cold day. The temperature is 40. Too cold.
That's creepy,
for
a thermometer.
Just a coat.
Really?
She will need her snowsuit if she wishes
a
to
snowsuit
for the Dutch
for 40 degrees. Clearly, this was written by somebody in Southern California.
Joan's brother. They choose wraps to keep all of their body warm
and free from communism. Any cyanide capsules in there? No, Mom. Good.
Mother is good to see Jim looking so well this morning. Their color is good. Their eyes alert.
Here's how you stuff
they're
a bra and trap a man.
Mother needs to get another supply of paper handkerchiefs.
Mother is raising Joan to be a world-class neurotic.
Jim's friend George is eating an apple as he waits for them. That is a wise no thank you, Joan.
Yeah, because apples
never
suck.
Share another's food. George has forgotten something. Something that helps keep him clean.
The Bible.
It's lucky for George that Joan has an extra tissue to lend him.
It's the last one, you freeloader.
Some children learn to jump or go around puddles. But George wades right into trouble.
The future is written for young George. He's a complete moron.
This is Miss May.
Welcome. I am Miss May. I'll be educating you today.
The children are getting ready for their Dutch festival.
Which is completely different from a Dutch oven festival, which isn't nearly as pleasant.
What the weatherman doll should wear today? A raincoat and umbrella? Oh, no. A snowsuit and galoshes to keep him warm and dry.
Ah, I was going to go with a pseudo-silk kimono and a Kaiser helmet. You know, looking at that picture of George, I think I know where this might end up. Oh, yeah.
George, you forgot something more important than your handkerchief. You forgot to cover... And cold germs travel on your sneeze or cough, you know.
Ah, this handkerchief is full of teacher loogies.
Why, cold germs can fly farther than Miss May can blow the feather. Cold germs can fly 8 feet to another child's nose.
And again, it's like this film with it, War with Apples.
People who put fingers into their mouths make it easy for cold germs to come to them.
Parents, please have your children defingered.
No, not that way, George. Blow your nose gently without pressing the opening of the nostrils closed.
Ah, come on, George. Put that kid in a sweatshop someplace. He's slowing everybody
and
down.
Your feet are wet. It's easy to catch cold when your body is chilly. You'd better go and see the school nurse. She'll help you.
Went to the nurse with a case of wet foot.
The nurse is examining Mary after her cold.
Okay, so let's fast forward a little bit through this. George goes to see the nurse, who keeps him uncomfortably close, tests whether or not he can blow his nose, no light at the end of that tunnel, and puts a cigarette in his mouth. Oh, no, the thermometer. Calls his mom, which is totally unfair because all he had was wet feet. I tried to perfect the call my mom, I want to go home thing for a long time. Here, look at this chart. Tell me what you prefer in your next child. There we go. Here, play with this doll. La, 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 la. Winnetka, apparently. And a bunch of kids in the bathroom. And, oh, look at all the germs.
One group keeps large drawings.
Don't look
pencils
at the camera.
Ready for use.
Those are jobs Joan and Jim could be learning to do at home, too. On Saturdays, they left to help us plan what we're going to do.
Yeah, I bet.
I'm so glad to get this health record sheet.
You sure that's not
your
the script?
Your check on Joan's habits at school will help me plan a corrective health program at home.
A corrective health program? Jeez. She must be reading Grime
and
Punishment.
And I
must
check on our office to see if we have the materials to carry on the school practices. Thank you for some grand ideas, Miss May. I'm going to visit school again some afternoon when I call for Joan. May I?
Wow.
Do come often. It is good for teachers
and children to have parents visit school. Yeah!
Since this turkey is almost 10 minutes long, I'm going to hit a few highlights.
And here are new cups. Each can have his own cup now. It prevents catching another's cold.
Oh, it's always bad when kids start acting up while you're shooting a film.
Father has taught Joan to spit into the toilet, for spitting spreads disease.
Apparently there's nothing wrong with brushing your teeth next to the toilet.
Here are the spoons. Keep away from persons with colds. And keep your hands clean while you're eating.
Remember to always shun the ill.
What's the trouble with Jim?
Really, what isn't wrong
with
Jim?
Breakfast, and he was restless as he slept.
Probably sick of shooting this movie.
He's cross and tired this morning. His throat isn't very red, but his eyes look queer.
What, you mean tasteful and color-coordinated?
So that the kermis has started. George's friends are selling the flowers they raised. They learn that flowers, like children, need plenty of sunshine, water...
To be buried in the backyard, and then covered with manure.
...to make them grow. Joan's friends are selling cheese, and they are careful to keep the food clean. You have seen these children learning to take care of themselves. Now, do you know why George and Jim missed the kermis?
Wouldn't you? Look at the damn thing. George and Jim are the only smart ones in this whole film.